software. Donkey Kong Country. This game was real huge for its graphics. Look at the graphics compared to most of the other games. Amazing. I mean, for 16-bit... For 16-bit game, that's pretty amazing. Okay, we're gonna erase game. Go to file 2. Okay, so it's kind of like... It seems like they kind of copied off Super Mario World. I mean, you got this map screen here. Actually, this is more like... Yeah, I guess this map screen is kind of like Super Mario World, but... Anyways, Congo Jungle is the first world. You get all these boards inside the world. Extra lives. Just like in Super Mario World, you collect coins, here you collect bananas. Pick this up and bounce it off the wall. Throwing at it, that's pretty cool. Ride it up to a certain point and then we'll go back and get some of the stuff that I'm missing. Here you got a rhino to ride, just like you got Yoshi and Super Mario World. The only thing is you can't take the rhino with you. You can only ride him on this board. There's my partner, Diddy Kong. So now if I get hit, well, first of all, if I get hit on this rhino, I jump off. Rhino, just like Mario jumps off Yoshi. First, I'm going to go in here so I can show this, and also so I can get my balloons, which would have floated away before when I went that way. Yeah, so once I'm off the rhino, if I get hit, Donkey Kong runs away off the board and Diddy replaces him. I can also switch between Donkey Kong and Diddy. There's many bonus stages in this game too. Barrel to break into stages, but I got the rhino, so I don't need it. Whoops, jumped too early. Want to match all three of them up. I got a fish. See, if I get three fish, I get to play the fish bonus stage. I get three rhinos, I play the rhino stage. Three ostriches, I play the ostrich bonus stage. And then there's three frogs with a frog bonus stage. Between Donkey and Diddy. Donkey's stronger, but Diddy seems to, like, he can jump higher. Press the A button. Want to switch characters. Yeah, they got a lot of cool, like, rain, snow. It goes from dark to day to night. Thank you. Okay, why won't he grab onto it? And when this game first came out, they actually sent videotapes to, I don't know if it was to people who were registered in a certain Nintendo club or something, but I got one. It was a 20-minute video showing all the bonus stages and all the fun of this game. It was enough to convince me to buy it. I cannot beat the game, though. Sometimes I get stuck on World 2, Minecart Carnage, but if I can pass that board, then I usually get to World 4-1. Jump up there, idiot. You can stop at Cranky's cabin and talk to him. Or you can skip it if you want. Hey boy, did you fetch me a paper? Or fetch me my paper? We were much better off in those days as well. Yeah, sentences are kind of... don't make sense sometimes. But you thought this was 64-bit, eh boy? I've got more gameplay in my little finger than you've got in this whole game. You know what they say, all graphics and no gameplay. 32 meg, that would be more than 30 games in my day. Maybe great games too. Back in my days, we used to have real gameplay. A leap of faith is all it takes to find Mikey and Barrel Cannon Canyon. If you bounce a keg off a wall and then jump on it, it goes back, you can ride it. Now off you go, see if you ain't finished this ridiculous quest without my help. I'll see if you can't. Reptile Rumble. With those little marks on the side of them like that, they shoot out automatically. If it's a barrel that doesn't have a mark, you have to press the button to shoot out. Oh, that was nasty. See, now I gotta get Donkey back by finding one of those DK barrels. If I get hit before then, I die. That's a save point, by the way, right there. Another feature they most likely got from Super Mario World. I think I threw the wrong wall. There's another fish. I need three of them. Rhino Board's probably my favorite bonus stage. You can do this, press down and Y. There's certain points where bananas will come out. You have to know where they are, though. Oh, check this out. If you just stand there... whoops. That's what happens if you stand on the edge. But if you just stand in the right spot, check out Donkey Kong. Thank you. check out this waterboard compared to the Mario waterboards. I have to say the graphics are pretty impressive for a Super Nintendo game. Upgrade. Wait till we see the next game, Tecmo Super Bowl 2 Special Edition. The field looks a lot better than it did in the previous Tecmo Super Bowl game. Stuck in the wall, it doesn't look right. Swordfish. There's another one in there. If you just sit there, the swordfish will automatically shoot at him. Which is kind of a cool feature. So if you're a little slow, the swordfish will help you out. Whoa, that was close. There's Funky's flights. I'm not going to stop at his place. Anyways, what you could do there is you could jump in his plane and you could go to the previous worlds. But since this is World 1, there's really nowhere to go. We'll wait till we get to World 2 and then go back. If I get that far. Girl Cannon Canyon. Goody down there? Guess not. Three of those things now, so I get to play the cool. Okay, so you gotta collect all these. And when the time runs out, you get an extra life for every 100 of these you've collected. I get 4 extra lives. Sometimes you gotta start off at the beginning of the board again. That should have opened up that secret passageway to a bonus stage. Failed. Stage back there. Save point. I am Candy Kong and this is my save point. If you want to save your current game, jump into my spinning save barrel. So 13 and 11%. And here's Very Naughty's Lair boss stage. Actually better at jumping. I think you could jump higher. So now we go on to Monkey Mines. Winky's Walkway. Now we get to do the ostrich stage. This one's not quite as fun. I think I usually only get like 3 extra lives out of this one. Instead of hovering on that last one, I decided just to fall to the ground and keep collecting more. But I notice it goes slower when you hover, so... By the way, this frog can jump on the bees. It can jump on a lot of bad guys that Donkey and Diddy can't. This next one is the one I struggle on sometimes. Sometimes I can pass it and keep on going all the way to the world port. Other times I get stuck and I just keep dying over and over. If I can't pass this port, I think what I'll do is I'll reset the game. And I'll play one of my other files and just go back. I'll try this like 3 times, so if I fail 3 times at it, then we're gonna go... Oh, that's close. This is going to be real hard for anyone who's never played the game before, but once you play it, you know exactly when to jump and where to jump. So, I really have no excuse for failing at the game other than my reflexes aren't as good as they used to be. I'm older. I feel elderly. Down for the very last one. Doubles everything you got. $5.55. Stage we haven't seen yet is the frog one. As far as the 4 animal stages. Oh. Okay, there's strike one. Still younger. Strike two. Right at the end of the board, too. I don't care how close to the end of the board I am, I'm at. I get strike three, we're going, resetting the game, and we're going to do some cheating just like they do. Problems with this game. I have this everything memorized where everything is. I got a 55-inch TV, so it's not like it's hard to see. I guess the only excuse I have is old age. I got proof that I'm old because my proof is in my previous videos. I complain a lot. That's what old people do. When you get to be old, you have a right to complain. It's like a law or something, or at least it should be. What was that? I jumped right on top of him. Actually, I think there's a bonus stage down there, but I just missed it. I lost my barrel. I know none of these have commands in them. I must be thinking of somewhere else. Kind of dark. I'm going to turn the color up. Wrong button. Better. See, I have to keep the color down on some of my old NES games because I know it's like Paperboy. It's too white. The streak kind of blends in with the characters and some of the other objects. When I start getting up to these, some of these games are going to need brightness. Jumping on top of him. That's the second time I did that. Jump on him and count it as a hit against me. Whoa, I didn't know there was an extra life there. Let's try and put bananas. I last time on Go Station, this one's kind of annoying. I usually always lose one of my characters towards the end of this board. I'm gonna go with Diddy because this board requires a lot of jumping. Stage and it didn't. Cheaters. Oh, I want my tire. Oh no, I'm not gonna make it past this board now. I heard Diddy, where is he? Oh! See? That's where I always die on this board. But I usually have the other character. See, that's what was supposed to happen last time. Save point again. Well, you guys really came a long way. Save with me now while you have a chance. I hope I can get to the usual point I get to before the hour. See those big blue guys? Diddy can't jump on them. I just bounce right off of them, but Donkey. You can jump on top of him. This way and you can go blinky once again. Mm-hmm. Who's gonna jump down? Oh, I guess if we get Winky, you can actually jump down and get those. I never thought about that before, though. No bananas. You know where some of them are, but there's others I can't remember if they got them or not. Bananas in the ground. You big ape, I could hear you coming from miles away. This was developed with the latest state-of-the-art 3D work thingies. Was it? Trouble with you kids is that you're all too soft. Old games are far harder than when I was young. We used to play for hours on a single screen game and think we were lucky when we were. You wouldn't last 2 minutes in a real game. Country with only one life, easy. Go bananas in the snake pit and the reptile rumble. Fetch the free tires to areas where they will help you win. Find hidden bonus levels. This stereo sound is making my tired old ears bleed. Turn it down before you go. You don't have to have a cranky's. Can, but I always liked it. Got some funny stuff to say. Starts off in the background, then it gets closer and it gets bigger and it looks like a blizzard. See, that's hard when they got two of them. There's another bonus stage where they only got one of them. That one's funner. Wait. That's kind of boring, huh? miserable fail. Not nasty. I usually don't never have problems on this board. I need Diddy's jumping abilities. Okay, that was the worst jumping ability I've ever seen. Sick of seeing all these guys. What is... This is getting sick. Left to get to the world 4-1. Oh, Diddy would have been able to get in there. This board is usually one of the hardest ones. I keep dying and it usually takes me quite a few tries. I'm sure we'll get to see the bonus stage back there. I don't think I've ever passed this stage in one life. Second barrel, the end, and the third, and the G in the last one. It took me a while to figure out how to play the game, and I forgot. Thank you. 5 minutes, I'm gonna quick skip to the old 4-1. See, this, I hate this board. I get so old seeing this stuff all the time. Are you kidding me? You know, this is the last time I'm trying this, and I'm gonna cheat. Okay, so we're going to reset the game. Show you a little cheat code thing you could do here too. Okay, go down to erase game, push B-A-R-R-A-L. Just gave me 50 extra lives. Okay, so here we are. This is the board I keep struggling against, Treetop Town. So here's what Forest Frenzy looks like. I'm going to do 3 strikes, 3 out with every board. Actually, I think I'm only going to do, like, 2 strikes. We are kind of low on time. Things can be annoying. That. Oh! I wasn't thinking, I was trying to jump on him. Okay, Tempest. Oh. No, I forget about that. I am going to go... Oh, we didn't get past this one yet. So I guess I won't be able to shovel the last board unless I can pass these within the next, like, 10 minutes. Show the last board because it was really cool, but I know I'm not going to have enough time. Chance to throw the barrel at him. Whoa! That was Donkey Kong Country. I hope you enjoyed it. Tomorrow I'm going to be doing Tecmo Super Bowl 2 Special Edition. Very rare game of the Tecmo Super Bowl games. I've actually never played that as a kid, never even heard of it as a kid, and I've done some research on it maybe within last year when I found it. So I decided to order it, and it was the most expensive game I ordered on eBay. Most games are like, the cheapest was probably like $2. The old Nintendo games, I think the most expensive is normally like $20. This one cost $42, but it's a pretty cool game. Tecmo Super Bowl 2 Special Edition. It was made 1994, shortly before the 95. Actually, I've got one. I heard it was actually released in January 95, but I put it in 94 because it's got the 94 rosters. It was made in 94. And we already have Tecmo Super Bowl 3 Final Edition, which is going to be our game for 95. And that's actually going to be our last game to finish up the Super Nintendo games. So, that was Donkey Kong Country. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you in Lambeau Field. Preseason game, Tecmo Super Bowl 2 Special Edition.